Runway 32, clear for takeoff, wind calm, runway heading.
Clear for takeoff, fly the runway heading, clear 425 Mike.
Cessna 39, Quebec, function make turn one, departing clear 45, runway 32, clear to land, wind calm.
Clear to land, Quebec.
Cessna 59 Delta, traffic's off your left side of the main track, Cherokee.
Each airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas. From the flight deck. Republic Airport is a medium-sized, primarily general and business aviation airport located on New York's Long Island. Located just east of the Village of Farmingdale, the airport is approximately 15 miles east of JFK and approximately 15 miles west of Long Island MacArthur Airport, located in the town of Islip. Farmingdale has non-standard-shaped Class Delta airspace that extends from the surface to 2,600 feet. The airspace also underlies the New York Class Bravo and is just west of the Islip Class Charlie. Pilots flying into FRG for the first time need to thoroughly understand the different requirements for operating in this complex mix of airspace. The traffic mix consists of everything from basic flight training aircraft all the way to air carrier class aircraft. There is a robust helicopter fleet as well, providing flight training along with several medevac operations. Numerous flight schools located on the airport help to push the daily traffic count to over 1,000 operations a day on a good VFR day. The diverse pilot experience levels, along with differing aircraft capabilities, make Republic an interesting and challenging airport for pilots and controllers. The airport configuration consists of two intersecting runways, 119er and 1432. A complex system of taxiways provide access to all FBOs, services, and ramp areas located on the west and northeast sides of the airport. In August of 2021, the airport completed a major project that relocated one runway and changed the taxiway identification for numerous intersections across the airport. Pilots are reminded to check the dates on all charts and maps, printed or electronic, before departing for any airport, including Farmingdale. While no official hotspots exist on the field, there are several areas that warrant extra attention and are unique to the operation. Pilots approaching from the north and northwest and cleared to land on runway 19er have mistaken runway 14 for their assigned runway. The implications here are obvious. Loading an instrument approach for your assigned runway is helpful in verifying that you are aligned on the proper final. Checking aircraft heading against your landing clearance will also help ensure you are landing on the correct surface. With heavy pattern traffic being the norm at Republic, it is also extremely important to listen to and understand the pattern entry you are issued from the tower on your initial call. While you may expect one kind of entry, do not be surprised if you are issued instructions that are not what you were expecting.
Make a left 360 to avoid extension.
Changes can be minor, or they can be significant. Phrases such as, remain clear of the Class Delta airspace, call again in 5 minutes, is not unheard of due to traffic volume at this airport. Another unique thing that happens at Republic concerns the use of lineup and wait. The lineup and wait rule does not allow a controller to have any aircraft clear to land on the runway that the aircraft is lining up and waiting on. Due to this rule, do not be confused if the tower calls you and states, landing clearance canceled. This is not an order to go around, nor is it a request for you to do anything else, such as implement S-turns or depart the final approach. The controller is simply complying with his or her rulebook and will re-clear you to land when appropriate. Pilots are advised to simply continue their approach as normal and wait for further instructions. Land and hold short procedures are also used when landing on runway 32. Keep in mind that the final decision whether to accept this type of clearance rests solely with the pilot in command. While the acceptance of a LAHSO clearance is ultimately up to the pilot in command, the place and time for a pilot to tell the controller that they are unable to accept a LAHSO clearance is not on short final. If you are in doubt or unsure about your ability to comply with the LAHSO clearance, say, unable, in plenty of time for the controller to devise another traffic plan. As mentioned earlier, the airport has undergone some important changes in terms of runway location and taxiway identification. It has also recently complied with the new runway safety area requirements that have necessitated moving hold short lines further away from the runway approach ends, usually on parallel taxiways. The changes in taxiway identification and hold short locations call for increased attention to taxiway markings and above-ground signage at all areas of the airport. Avoiding heads-down time while taxiing will go a long way to help pilots avoid a serious ground movement error. Pilots taxiing to Runway 1 via Alpha, Bravo, have sometimes continued on Alpha without making the turn onto Bravo, crossing the Runway 1, 19er hold short line. This type of situation can be mitigated by maintaining a high degree of situational awareness at all times. Be aware of all signs and markings and understand your taxi route prior to beginning taxi. When taxiing to Runway 1, pilots need to be aware that taxiway mic does not connect to Runway 1. There is a grass area between taxiway mic and Runway 1. The full length of Runway 1 begins at taxiway Golf Niner and Bravo 6. Pilots should use extra caution when operating on the apron area located between Hangar 2 and 3. This is because the hold short position marking for Runway 1, 19er on taxiway Golf 1 may appear sooner than expected. In addition, pilots operating on taxiway Quebec need to be aware of vehicles operating adjacent to the taxiway. The next issue primarily concerns pilots departing Republic to the north and northwest. In certain situations, primarily when JFK is landing on parallel runways 22 left and right, Republic may assign some of its Class Delta airspace to the north to New York approach. This is to accommodate the IFR downwind traffic being vectored to JFK. This is a normal operation. This is only an advisory to pilots departing Farmingdale. Do not be surprised to see heavy jet traffic above you. One last reminder when operating at an airport with a control tower. If you are ever in doubt or unsure of any instruction or clearance, ask the tower. They are there to help. Being aware of the configuration challenges at Republic Airport will help pilots make better decisions, and along with the ATC tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the Republic Airport in Farmingdale, New York. It's always better to know before you go.